Namo Namaha students, hello. I am Ruchita and today in Sanskrit grammar, I am taking you through something very, very simple and very, very interesting. And the topic is use of Tvam and Bhavan. Well, students, let us begin. Here, while we see our friend eating, we ask our friend, Tum kya kha rahe ho? Tu kai khata hais? What are you eating? And similarly, in Sanskrit, if we are to address our friend or someone younger, we say, Tvam kim khadasi? Well, if we were to address someone, an elderly person, we would ask the same thing as, Aap kya kha rahe ho? Tumhi kai khat ahat? What is the respected one eating? And likewise, in Sanskrit, we would address the respected person or the elderly person and say, Bhavan kim khadati? So students, I am sure you have understood that we address people differently to show respect. And what is the word that we use? Here we can see that while changing Tvam to Bhavan, there is a change in the verb as well. And to be very specific, it is the verb ending that changes. So Tvam changes to Bhavan and Si changes to Ti. So let us understand how this change takes place. And to understand that, let us know more about Tvam and Bhavan. Here we have Tvam. The word Tvam means you. It is used for a friend or a younger person. It is the singular form of the second person pronoun Yushmad. And while the verb is being used, it is going to take the second person singular form. So, this can be used in any tense and mood. Let us take an example of Tvam with a parasmaipada dhatu like gamagaccha to go. So in present tense, I have the sentence tvam gacchasi, which means you are going. If I were to have the same sentence in imperfect past tense, I would say tvam agacchah, which means you went. And if I were to use the imperative mood, then I would have the sentence as tvam gaccha, you may go. And in the potential mood, we can have the same sentence becoming Tvam gachhehe, which means you will go or you would go. Now students, like we have a parasmaipada dhatu, we can have an atmanepada dhatu or an atmanepada root. And for this, we have a root like ram. Ram, no, it means to enjoy. So you have Tvam ramase in present tense, which means you are enjoying. In the imperfect past tense, it would be Tvam aramathaha, which means you enjoyed. And in the imperative mood, you would say Tvam ramasva, which means you may enjoy. And in the potential mood, you have that word becoming ramethaha, Tvam ramethaha, which means you would enjoy or you will enjoy. So we have seen what happens for Tvam. Let us now understand Bhavan. The word Bhavan means the respected one. It is used for a respected or an elderly person. It is the singular form of the third person pronoun Bhavat. And obviously, the verb used with it has to be the third person singular. Again, this can be used in any tense or mood. So we have an example for Bhavan. For a parasmaipada dhatu like gamagaccha as we saw earlier, in present tense we have Bhavan gacchati, which means the respected one is going. If it is the imperfect past tense, we have agacchat, Bhavan agacchat, which means the respected one went. For the imperative mood, we have gacchatu, that becomes Bhavan gacchatu, the respected one may go. And in the potential mood, we have gachet, Bhavan gachet, which means the respected one will or would go. And for the atmanepada dhatu, just like we saw ram, here let's take ram and get the forms. Bhavan ramate, which means the respected one is enjoying. If it is past tense, it will be Bhavan aramata, which means the respected one enjoyed. If it is the imperative mood, you have Bhavan Ramatam, which will mean the respected one may enjoy. And in potential mood, we have Bhavan Rameta, which means the respected one would or will enjoy. So students, here we have seen the difference between Tvam and Bhavan.